And a good morning to you. We're standing. We have been talking all morning long about the flood protection in St. Bernard Parish, whether you're inside the flood protection, outside the flood protection. We're standing in Verrett, Louisiana, just inside the flood protection. Joining me now, Fred Everhardt, who is councilperson, District E here in St. Bernard Parish. What are we expecting today? What do you think?
We're expecting some high tide and some wind. Hopefully it keeps going to the east, but we're preparing for the worst and hoping for the best.
You know, it's not unusual outside the flood protection, as we're talking about, to get flooding in that area when you have that strong east wind. When it comes in sustained, the wind holds it in there. It's not an unusual thing to happen.
Now more than ever. Tide comes out so fast down here due to the loss of land from Hurricanes Katrina and Rita and Ike and Gustav now, that if we don't get no protection soon, we are going to be the Barry Island right here. But you're right, it does come in considerably fast now. It's like an interstate now.
Yeah, when you look at it from the air, you realize how much land is not there anymore.
It's gone. We was out with the Corps engineers a couple days ago in the airboat, and I basically almost got lost in the marsh because I ain't had no more landmarks to look for. And you can just about run it almost anywhere. You know, it's bits and pieces, marsh, a friend of mine told me. You don't have no more consolidated marsh to hold that water back anymore. It's just wide open. Something needs to be done, and it needs to be done soon.
You know, they've closed the Mr. Go now.
Right.
That helps a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
How can that help us in this particular event?
Well, it's not designed for a tidal surge. It's just designed for a plug. That's what it is. It's just to deauthorize the deep vessel travel for the ships and the barges. And what it did, it alters the current through different bayous. So we're still getting the tide, and we're still getting the high water and as fast as it's supposed to come. But it's coming through different ends. Now we got the dike canal, and it's coming through Bayou Lutra. So it didn't really help anything with tidal surge, but it re-altered it, you know. And it's not any kind of key to a tidal surge or whatever. It's just a plug. That's what it was designed for, right across Bayou Terre Buff Ridge.
Now, very quickly, we were looking at a number of the trailers and trucks. I mean, these are the people that know what's coming, know what's happening,
right.
So they go ahead and park and make sure their equipment is safe.
Last night, after our briefing, I went down to the island, and I counted about 100
trailers. You talk about the island, you talk about
Delacroix Island. We went to down there, and I counted about 100 trailers, and we counted about 100 and something back in Wycloski. You know, if this storm would have came further west, and these trailers create like little missiles, and Ike and Gustav, these trailers, you know, they was parked all over the roads after the water went down. They was in the canals. They was underneath the boat slips. They was under the houses, and it caused some structural damage. That's the only concern I had when I talked to the parish president early this morning, last night and this morning, that, you know, that we got to find a way. If we're going to get a 4 or 5 foot tidal surge, we got to get these little trailers out of here some kind of way. So, you know, I was kind of a little disappointed that did it in heedal warnings, and this is what you got right here. You should have had them lined up all the way past the 40 off the levee hump down there, but, you know, I mean, we'll find out this morning.
Yeah, last question, you know, I'll let you go because I know you're trying to do your job. 9 o'clock this morning, we should get an update?
9 o'clock, yeah. We have an update in the council chambers at 9 o'clock with just us, and probably GOSEP's going to be on there too.
All right, Fred Everhardt, thank you very, very much. Parish council person for District E here in St. Bernard Parish. He's in his truck. He's out here running the roads trying to just make sure that everybody that needs something has what they need. And as you heard, at 9 o'clock, there should be some updated information coming out of the governmental building here. We already know that this voluntary evacuation is ongoing here in St. Bernard Parish. And, of course, no school in St. Bernard today. So we'll keep you posted on everything that's going on. We expect Parish President Craig Tafaro to drive by kind of like Fred did here in a few minutes, and we'll get a word from him as well. In the meantime, on your side here in St. Bernard, Heath Allen, WDSU News.